Hey everyone, it's Amador, and I have just basically a random haul with all kinds of stuff that I mostly got last week or got in the mail. I just haven't had a chance to post them since I haven't been feeling well. So, but let me start with a bunch of stuff at Hobby Lobby that they have. They have this section where they have like gable boxes and all these things in like craft and white, and you can just alter them. It's super cool. And these, I think somebody else showed these as well. And these are the larger size of it under the Saxon things. Chalkboard little gift bags, treat bags. They have a smaller size as well, so I thought those were cute for racks or whatever that we could draw on them and, you know, whatever. So anyway, they also have these, and they come in a set of two, and they're these little cardboard boxes, but these are super cool. I don't know if anyone can make a box, but these ended up being like $1.50 for two. If you have a chunky charm or anything like that that you're shipping, you can either ship it just like this or, you know, add it in a box, and that way it stays in one place. And, you know, I thought these were super cool. You can alter them as well, but hey, you know, whatever. They also have, I found these just randomly, these wacky wobblers. I know I use acetate. I've always wanted to try these. And I usually use acetate for, like, whatever item I want to bounce and stuff like that. But I figured, hey, I used my coupon on this. They were like 3-something or whatever. Also from Hobby Lobby, they have these new in that Saxon things section. And the only reason I got all these things were because since it's part of their Paper Studios line, which is the Hobby Lobby brand, whenever their Paper Studio stuff is 50% off, that's when I go usually go crazy. But they have these, and because these are $12.99 for a set of four, and they're glass, though. These cute, cute little mason jars. I got a couple sets. And if you look, they actually have it says mason jar on the side. And they have really nice tops and everything. So let me show you in reference to, like, what size they are. If you guys have gotten the other items before from these things, let me grab another little jar. If you guys have the Tim Holtz Distress Glitter, this is the size, and this is the size of the jars, of the plastic ones from Hobby Lobby, from the Paper Studio section. So these are much bigger than this, basically the same design and everything. I don't know if they have the same distributor, don't care, whatever. These are larger than this one, so you guys can put your glitter. I actually have in mine, this is German glass glitter that I got from P, and it's pretty heavy, and you can hear the German glass glitter. Like I said, these are bigger than the Tim Holtz ones. So that's what I keep in my revolving tray. And these jars, so now you can see the size. These are the sizes of the jars. The Tim Holtz one, the plastic ones, and these are the glass mason jars. So they're glass and they're super cute, so they're kind of worth it, you know. But if not, hey, for kicks and giggles, it'll make your craft room look really cute. You can paint them and everything. And they're really nice, sturdy glass. Like I said, they come in a set of four. Super freaking cute. I grabbed the only sets that they had because they were on sale. So yeah, so, and talking about mason jars, I got another mason jar stamp set. And honestly, I need a mason jar stamp set like I need another hole in the head because it was nuts. But it's this one right here. It's from Inkadikadoo, and I got it at Michael's. And this is a newer set. Maybe it might not be newer, but I haven't seen it until now. And just to show you why I said I need another stamp, like a mason jar stamp, like I need a hole in the head, I have this one from Fiskars. I have this one from Hobby Lobby. I have this Lawn Fawn one with the matching die. I have this one from Recollections, which has the little ladybugs and all of these other accessories. Very much like the, Paper Tray Ink or whatever. So a lot of these very similar to that. I have this old wooden one from Inkadikadoo, which, by the way, I learned it's basically the same damn thing. So on this new one, it has cute little things like save the date, you're invited, to and from, which is really cute, a little label as well. It has this one with the lid, and has this large mason jar and this small one. Now, I grabbed this because I was curious to see if it matched the punch. This is the mason jar punch from EK Success or whatever, to see if it matched or it could coordinate with the actual stamp. And it's pretty close. So if you look, this is the actual stamp, this stamp right here, and it's punched with the punch. So it's not exactly like right around the border like this one would be from Lawn Fawn, but honestly, I mean, how cute is that still? This is just some scratch paper I had. So I stamped it and then I punched it. And if you're not careful, you'll punch into the actual lid. So, but if you look, it's pretty good size, and it's pretty close to it. So honestly, that would make a really cute, like, to and from tag or whatever, save the date. So Now, as far as this, if you guys got this, I've seen people sell this for, like, an absurd amount of money, like, for $20 on the scrapyard and other places. This one is also from Inka Dinka Doo, I believe. I don't know. I got it from Michael's, but this thing, as I opened it and I checked, it's the same damn size. The only difference is that this one has shading right there, and it has, like, a wider line at the bottom. But it's the same. Get rid of that. Same thing as this. So if you guys already have this, you're basically buying the same one, just a little bit of a difference right there. But if anything, you can use the, you know, the label or whatever. Of course, use my coupon on that one. And sometimes when I take Nathan with me, the only reason Nathan is going is basically so I can use an extra coupon. But yeah, so like I said, if you guys, and basically what I did was I took this stamp over to where they have the punches. I took, you know, you can open the bottom of it, and I laid it over to see if it would fit. He's like, what are you doing? I'm like, I'm making sure it fits. So, but yeah, so there you go. So you guys can totally use that with that punch if you guys wanted an actual, and like I said, it's pretty close, you know. Unless somebody makes another one, that's about as close as we're going to get to that. But I figured somebody eventually would make one. So yeah, oh, and I also got from the scrapyard, talking about some overpriced stuff, I got, this wasn't overpriced really, I got this set, and this is, I think is an Avery L set, and it's the Bonjour, the Bonjour set, and it has, you guys know I love me some French macarons, the bow, and obviously someone didn't, you know, either couldn't clean their stamps or whatever, but it came with the dies, so that's the only reason I got it. And I think I got it for like $12 or something, like $12 or $15, and it came with the die, and that way I don't have to look for it. But so yeah, so I got that. Like I said, I need more mason jar stamps. Like I need a hole in the head. So let me show you the last thing that I actually got at Hobby Lobby, and I got these sewing desk machine drawer, the faux ones, and it's, let me see, I'm trying to get in frame. It has this medallion and a glass knob and everything. They're really cute. They're already vintage distressed, so it's going to go fabulously in my craft room. And the cool thing, it has sections, so it has these four sections. And just, you know, to give you guys an idea on the size, these Avery L plastic die, stamp, storage containers, whatever they are, they fit perfectly in this section, and there's three of them. So, and it's like about 14 inches long and about, you know, whatever wide. But yeah, so these are super cute. And the cool thing is, I still have a sticker on these. They were on clearance for $13.60. Regularly, $39.99. That's crazy. You guys have lost your damn minds over at Hobby Lobby. But they were on clearance for $13.60, and I grabbed a couple of them for me to put them on my my hutch so I can store stuff. I'm going to put laces and trims or junk or whatever. But the cool thing, if you guys wanted to use these, you know, have a little bit more vintage, shabby chic look to your storage die or your stamp die, these, they have their, and they, these Avery L pockets, bags, I don't know what the hell they call them, fit perfectly there. So, super, super awesome. I also got two stamps from the Greeting Farm. I've been wanting them, but I was waiting for the other one to be restocked, so I don't have to pay double shipping. I got this one. This is the Skyward Anya, because the cool thing is I can use the hat and the goggles and everything for another, for all the other stamps if I wanted to. So that's, and the scarf too, all that stuff you can basically, you know, use for another one, because it doesn't have like a hand or anything over it, so that's pretty cool. The one thing that I order it for was just for that. So basically I paid $13 for that little itty bitty frappuccino cup, so that way I can use it with my other stamps. So once again, because it's on top of everything, you can use it for the other stamps. So that's what I was totally been wanting to, because I do like my caramel macchiato frappuccinos. But anyway, so yeah, those are the other things along with all the other stuff that I got. Guys, check out those stores. I don't know why we promote them, not like we're getting major discounts, and there's always that one employee that does not want to let you use that coupon. Like, it's not going to kill you, dude. Just use the coupon. So anyway, so yeah, talk to you guys later. You guys go find some goodies, and I hope you guys enjoy. Bye, everyone.